fact that this was when they didn't even know what, you know, it certainly didn't know it was going to be such a big hit. And the pilot episode was only 1 hour long, and they didn't know how people would take to the sort of modern updating of it. So I did that, and then the pilot was aired, I think, and then it was a good year later when they said, oh, we want to shoot the first episode again, but it's now 90 minutes, but we want you to do play the role of Mike Stamford. And, yeah, that's how it all came about, really.
Can you tell me what it was like working with the actors? And I'm guessing, how many takes was it?
I'd known of their work and was an admirer of Martin and Benedict's work before the series, especially Martin was in The Office. I liked his persona in that. I thought he was a very good actor, and I didn't know either of them personally, but they were absolutely right from day one, considering they were, you know, those big stars, and they were just lovely, really easy to act alongside, which is always very good if that, you know, the lead actors put you in your ease, and you're going to go and produce your best work if that happens. As I remember, it was the very famous scene where Sherlock says the address is 221B Baker Street, and the scene in the lab between the three of us. We spent a whole day on that, so I guess probably about sort of 7 or 8 takes of each shot. But it was very good fun, and the director Paul McGuigan was excellent, and I'd known his work through some films that he'd done. But yeah, he runs a very tight ship, and it was great the first day, and I sort of thought, wow, it was very impressive.
You were mentioned in the wedding, but episode, but you were actually away or working on another job.
Yes, I was in the middle of a play in the West End called War Horse, which I know has been on Broadway. Unfortunately, sometimes schedules can't be worked around, and it would have taken, I didn't have any holiday left to take from the theatre show I was doing, so that was a real shame, because then you sort of, people, but it's quite funny, you talk to some of the fans at the convention or at stage door, whatever show I'm doing, and they've got all these theories about why Stamford wasn't at the wedding, and they're like, really? Oh no, I was doing a play. And it's like, oh, you're annoyed with for getting married, and they're like, really? No, not at all. It's a character.
You said you went to a convention. Is that 221B you speak of?
Yes, yeah, 221B in Atlanta. I'd not done a convention before, so I had no idea what to expect. And unlike, say, Comic Con or something like that, where there's a panel, it was just me. So it was even more sort of scary. But it was absolutely lovely. And I remember having a question and answer session and saying, one of the questions was, do you think we're strange or weird for dressing up? And I said, no, because I'm a big soccer fan, a big football fan, and sometimes we wear the replica shirts, so we're dressing as our heroes as well. And so I don't think it's strange, and they loved that. They thought that was pretty, because, you know, it's not very nice. It's sort of, you're just doing your thing, and you're getting people sort of bad-mouthing you, calling you freaks and things like that. And I think it's lovely that people are coming from all over the states, and they meet at conventions, and they've got this whole friendship group, which is really important to them, and they feel like they can totally be themselves, hang out at the convention. So it was a real eye-opener to know how much the fans, absolutely, it's their world, you know, the series, and how deeply they care about it. But it's very, very touching.
Yeah, and I tell you what, it's, I do that too. I cosplay sometimes. Well, I've been thinking about doing Miss Hudson, because that way I can, you know, from my age, because I'm in my, to show my age, I'm in my mid-40s. So I said, this is something, a costume I can grow into over the years, you know, because you're never too old to be Miss Hudson. And so I said, I've been tempted to do that. And I did do a bearskin cap Sherlock from the third season. And the fans just, and I said, I don't care how old I am, I'm going to enjoy it. I met a lady out there that was 72 years old, dressing up in costume.
Yeah,
because that's what she loves.
At 221B, there was certainly, there was people there, three generations of one family, you know, and they're absolutely brilliant. And they're so inventive. That, I mean, it's not just the, I like the fact that it's not just the main characters. Someone will come as a waiter who's in the background of a shot, and then it's like, oh, who have you come as? Oh, I've come from the waiter from series, you know, series 4, episode 2. And wow, that's so, some of the costumes are absolutely, I had to be, sort of compare for the, fashion show, the sort of costume parade, and I was amazed by how much work had gone into some of the costumes. Somebody came as a fridge, and when you opened the fridge door, was just their head on a plate from absolutely incredible.
I think it's really amazing, the fans that put so much time into it. They really do have a passion, a love for Sherlock.
Yeah, absolutely. I think it's wonderful.
So you said that you're a fan of, what was it, sports? Is it a certain sport team?
Newcastle United. They play in the Premier League.
And you wear costumes that kind of represent the team.
We just wear the same shirts as the players wear on the pitch. So, yes, we're just, we are also dressing up as our heroes.
That's pretty cool. And speaking of heroes, or even Sherlock, did you were you a fan of Sherlock as a kid? Did you ever read any of the stories? Or?
I hadn't read any of the novels until I did the series, but I've subsequently read a couple of the novels. But I was a big fan of, I liked the classic Jeremy Brett series. That was the one that I could remember from when I was a kid, and so it was, I thought it was very brave of Mark and Steve Moffat to update it, because that's, I think, what they were worried about, that people would say, oh no, it's got to be set in Victorian London, it's got to be that, and they've proven that if the story is strong enough, then, and the characters are well played enough, portrayed, that people will just get into the stories. I mean, I can never, when I first read the script, I can never second guess who doing it. I don't think I'd be very good at being a Sherlock character.
Yeah, and I tell you what, I read a lot on Conan Doyle, and I'm big into the Victorian Sherlock, and I loved that they actually took us back for that. For one of the episodes.
Because
I love the clothing from that time period.
Yeah.
I do a lot of like reenactment stuff. I love wearing Victorian dresses and such. And, so that time period is a beautiful time period.
Yeah.
But, I think
it was,
they've
it
done.
It was very interesting to do the spectacle.
Yeah, that's right, because you were in that episode.
Yeah, and it was almost exactly the same scene, but reimagined in a Victorian period, and that was a really good fun, seeing the boys sort of, and Molly's character's absolutely brilliant, the way that they made her, was really good fun.
Yeah, and it was probably fun being able to dress up too. But you've mentioned you do theater too, right?
Yes, a lot of theater, yes.
So you probably wear different outfits like that. Have you ever done period acts
Yes,
like that?
so War Horse is set during the period of the Great War, the First World War, 1914 to 1918. So there was a lot of period costume in that, and then I previously done Charles Dickens, Nicholas Nickleby, and I've done a lot of Shakespeare as well, so going back right to the sort of 16th, 17th century, the Globe Theatre. I've done a lot of period drama. So yeah, it's good fun, always good fun dressing up.
And so speaking of period stuff, do you prefer that over the more modern stuff, or are you easy going with any of the acting that you do?
Yeah, I think variety is the best thing. You know, I love to do a period piece and then follow it up with a piece of modern television, and then a radio play. I wouldn't like to ever be involved in just one medium. And I think that's what's nice about both Martin Freeman and Benedict Cumberbatch is that they have a real love of the stage. So like Martin did Richard III and Benedict did famous Hamlet last year, and they keep coming back to the stage because I think it is something you can lose. You get a lot of film actors who haven't been on stage for 20 years or more, and I think it's a sort of thing you should keep coming back to, and I'm really pleased they do.
Yeah, I noticed that too. And I, speaking of Martin, I'm going to be able to see his play in October. He's
Yes.
working. And I'm kind of excited for it because you'll probably laugh, but I've never, aside from things I used to do in school, because we would have like Christmas plays and so forth, I've never actually been to the theater.
Oh my
And
goodness.
so I'm excited. I ended up getting front row seats and I said, this is my first time. It's,
Wow.
are you going to be in the play? Do you know? Well, I mean, I know that's a funny question. I don't know. They've got a lot of actors in these plays, but.
I'm not going to be in it, but I'm certainly going to go and watch it. Yes, I'm going off to do a play of my own. I'm going on holiday, on vacation soon, and then when I come back, I'm starting a new theatre play.
So you're going to be working on one yourself then?
Yes.
Okay. Yeah, 'cause I was going to say then maybe I'd get to see both of you up on stage. Yeah, I mean, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to try to go and see him. And you were talking about the director that you before my husband called.
Yes, Jeremy.
So you've worked with him too then.
Yes, 3 times at the did some Shakespeare with him at the Globe Theatre, and also some modern plays with him. So he's very good. Very good indeed.
I think this modern play is going to be fun. I just
Yeah, oh
wish
yeah,
I
and
would have
that'll be.
gotten to see a period piece while I was over there. But I've only got like a week over there, so I'm going
Yeah,
to
all
make the
right.
best of it.
Yeah.
And
No, it'll be.
it's funny because I'm going over for a Sherlock convention.
Ah.
Yeah, so it's going to be, kind of like I'm going to see London for a couple days. My friend's going to take me to see the Tower of London. And
Yes.
different sites like that. I was really would love to see, Buckingham Palace, but it's
Yep.
kind of like with a week's time, I'm going to have to try to squeeze everything in and then maybe just go over there another time and just have it for sightseeing to see places. You know, 'cause she said within a week's time, you're never going to see everything.
No, you can only do a little slice of it. But, yeah, see a bit of history and a bit of theatre, that'll all be good.
Yeah,
It's lovely.
I think it'll be a wonderful trip. It's going to be an interesting experience. I've never been overseas. I've flown all over the States, but I've never been, into another country, so.
Yeah, oh, you'll have a great time.